Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what you are doing, you will be successful. A very good morning to everyone present here. It is our pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to you all for this ATEL program on challenges and opportunity in execution of artificial intelligence for electric vehicle design. Your presence makes us happy.
Prayer is the song of the heart. Every positive thought is a silent prayer, which will change your life. Now I call upon Mrs. Satya to unlock the door of our minds with their prayer song.
எனக்கு வேண்டும் வரங்களை இசைப்பேன் கீழாய் கணபதி. எனக்கு வேண்டும் வரங்களை இசைப்பேன் கீழாய் கணபதி. மனதில் சலனம் இல்லாமல் மதியில் இருளி தோன்றாமல் மனதில் சலனம் இல்லாமல் மதியில் இருளே தோன்றாமல் நினைக்கும் பொழுது நின் மௌன நிலை வந்திடனி செயல் வேண்டும். நினைக்கும் பொழுது நின் மௌன நிலை வந்திடனி செயல் வேண்டும். கணக்கும் செல்வம் நொறு வயது இவையும் தரணி கடவாயே. கணக்கும் செல்வம் நொறு வயது இவையும் தரணி கடவாயே. எனக்கு வேண்டும் வரங்களை இசைப்பேன் கீழாய் கணபதி.
Thank you, Mrs. Satya. Extend your arm in welcome to the future. The best is yet to come. Now I would like to invite Dr. D. Srividya, Associate Professor of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, to deliver the welcome address.
Thank you, Mosi. Good morning to all in this enlightening morning. It's indeed my great pleasure to welcome you all to this AICT Training and Learning Academy sponsored faculty development program on challenges and opportunities in execution of artificial intelligence for electrical vehicle design. I, on behalf of the UBLI department, welcome our honorable chairman, Lion, Dr. K.S. Rangaswamy, MJF, and our vice chairman, Mr. R. Srinivasan, K.S. Rangas Education Institute, for this FTP on his absence. I welcome our Chief Executive Officer, Dr. K. Thyagaraja, KSR Education, who always been our guide. I welcome our young and dynamic principal, Dr. R. Gopalakrishnan, who constantly encourages and guides us for enhancement of the institution. I welcome our beloved chief guest, Dr. S. Tangavel, Dean Academic, NIT Pondicherry, who always been a great pillar to our institution. I also welcome our respected HOD, Dr. N.K. Ilango, who guided us to coordinate this program. I also welcome our faculty and students who supported in organizing this FTP. Last but not the least, I welcome all the participants without whom the program will not be fulfilled. I once again welcome all. Thank you. Over to MOC.
Thank you, ma'am. A good teacher, like a candle, it consumes itself to light the way for others, and they can inspire hope, ignite the imagination, and install a love of learning. Now I would like to invite our head of department, Dr. M.K. Ilango, Electrical and Electronic Engineering, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, to speak about the ATEL Faculty Development Program.
Yeah. Good morning, and wish you a happy new year 2021 to one and all present over here. In association with Dr. D. Srividya, let me join and welcome again today's chief guest, Dr. S. Tangavel, Professor, Dean Academics, National Institute of Technology, Puducherry, Chief Executive Officer, Dr. K. Thyagaraja, sir, CEO, KSR Educational Institutions, our dynamic principal, Dr. R. Gopalakrishnan, organizing team members, faculties of Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, and participants all over the India, welcome you all. It gives me immense pleasure to deliver HOD's address and about the FDP on 5 days of faculty development program on challenges and opportunities in the execution of artificial intelligence for electric vehicle design. Actually, by initiation of our beloved principal, Dr. R. Gopalakrishnan, we submitted the proposal to conduct the Atal FDP on middle of this March 2020, that is just before 1 week of lockdown period. I noticed the information from Atal mail that more than 1,000 plus applications received by Atal from various eligible engineering colleges to conduct a faculty development program, and only 416 applications are shortlisted to conduct a FDP. Even out of 416 shortlisted proposals, only less than 10 number of institutions received more than one number of Atal program. I am very happy to announce that our college, KS Rangasani College of Technology, bagged two number of programs under Atal scheme to conduct a faculty development program. One is, one is from Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, and another one from Department of Computer Science Engineering. My duty to thank the resource persons on the 5 days faculty development program named up P. Swamasundaram, Professor Triple E Anna University, Chennai, Dr. M. Arun, Associate Professor, School of Electronics Engineering, AIT University, Vellore, Dr. Muruganandam Ponnusamy, Professor and Registrar, St. Gibbs College of Engineering, Kerala, Dr. N. P. Subramaniam, Associate Professor, Pondicherry Engineering College, Pondicherry, Dr. Tushar Konil Dera, Associate Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, National Institute of Technology, Durgapur, West Bengal, Dr. Kirubhagaran, Professor and Head, St. Joseph Institute of Technology, Chennai, Dr. Selvu Kumar, Assistant Professor, Triple E, SRM Institute of Science and Technology, Chennai, and internal resource persons, Dr. D. Srividya, Dr. S. Gomethi, and Dr. Hemamalini from Department of MBA. On behalf of Department of Triple E and my own behalf, I thank all the resource persons for readily accept our invitation and going to deliver quality lecture on 5 days FDP program. As a coordinator of Atal FDP, I can approve only 200 eligible participants. That number of participants applied is 248 from 17 states of India. Participants have registered. Just I will list out what are the participants. 11 from Andhra Pradesh, 1 from Bihar, 1 from Chhattisgarh, 2 from Delhi, 3 from Haryana, 2 from Jammu and Kashmir, 9 from Karnataka, 5 from Kerala, 2 from Madhya Pradesh, 19 from Maharashtra, 2 from Odisha, 3 from Rajasthan, 7 from Telangana, 9 from Uttar Pradesh, 7 from Uttarakhand, 5 from West Bengal, and finally 110 participants from Tamil Nadu. In addition, with above more than 10 number of participants have personally called me and asked to approve, but as per the Atal scheme, I couldn't admit more than that. And as a coordinator of 5 days Atal FDP, I assure you that we will conduct the event in an efficient manner and fulfill all the participants' objectives. We all know well, we are all faculties, objectives will be met out only with your support. So as a participant, you know well, in order to get certification, you should at least maintain 80% of attendance in 5 days FDP, and you should secure more than 60% of marks in all assessments. Assessment has been planned at the end of the day, that is just before valedictory function. With these few words, I would like to complete the HOD's address. I wish all the participants to have a good learning and make use of this opportunity. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. The good teacher explain, the superior teacher demonstrate, the great teacher inspire. A dream become a goal when action is taken toward its achievement. Now I would like to invite our Chief Executive Officer, Dr. K. Tyagaraja, KSR Education Institution, to address the gathering.
Very pleasant. Good morning to all of you who are joined in the virtual AICT-sponsored training program for the members of faculty. the most respected chairman, Lion Dr. K.S. Rangaswamy, the founder president of KSR Education Institutions, the respected vice chairman through R. Srinivasan, respected the principal of K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, Dr. Gopalakrishnan, the distinguished chief guest and former colleague of K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, Dr. Thangavel, the head of the Department of Electrical Engineering, Dr. Ilango, the coordinators of this program, and the members of faculty of the department and other departments, the team at MOC. A very pleasant good morning to all of you. It is indeed a great pleasure for me to associate myself in the inaugural session of a week long, the ATEL faculty training program sponsored by AACT. At the outset, I wholeheartedly welcome, along with the HODs and Dr. Srividya, the invite, and I also welcome Dr. Thangavel, who has readily accepted our invitation to be a part of this inaugural the session. Welcome, Dr. Thangavel. And I also see that the program has invited a number of faculty across the across India from NITs and IITs and other the universities, which are very important, and the experts are well versed in this particular area, so that it will be very useful for the participants in this the program. Coming to the topic, the challenges and opportunities in execution of artificial intelligence in electrical vehicle design. So I believe that execution of artificial intelligence into the electric vehicle, and also it may also be useful for the automated vehicles. And this part of the thing is, it's as of now, people are calling it artificial intelligence, but we are using artificial intelligence without knowing that we have in practice in the control of electrical machines and its many in the management of the power systems. We are actually continue to use the artificial intelligence concept without knowing that this is what is artificial intelligence. So if you look at the topic, the challenges and opportunities in electrical vehicle design, it is, I take it that part in apart from that in execution of artificial intelligence, but electrical vehicle design is one of the most important things as an electric engineers, and also the electronics and communication engineers, which together have to participate in the design of electrical vehicle. So if you look at the entire electrical engineering gamut, if you look at these, there are a lot of opportunities and for to become entrepreneurs, particularly the manufacture of the devices, and also the sensors, which are very much essential for the control of electrical machines and also the power system. And in particular, in this context, the kind of sensors which is very essential, you know, for the electrical vehicle design is one part which is thing. The second part is that the entrepreneurship is the charging of the charging stations, and also effective charging, fast and as well as slow and steady charging. There are three different categories as far as the charging stations are concerned. So this is another opening up for the kind of different kinds of the charging systems, and also the evaluation there are batteries are evolutions of evolutionary changes have taken place in the case of the battery design. So we have good opportunities in the manufacture of the batteries themselves, and the more importantly, the next is the kind of the motor which is to be used. So conventionally, people are used to the DC machines. Now invariably, both for the two-wheelers, three-wheelers, and as well as the four-wheelers, maybe the BLDC motors will be the most optimum motor which we can use it. So one thing that on the BLDC is that its control is simpler compared to the other motors like SRM, which switch reluctance motors, which are also coming up for the electric vehicle, the applications. So you have a lot of opportunities as far as in the design of the motors, because the design of the motors vary depending upon the speed which is requirement and also the power which is required. So like what you can call it as the 100cc vehicle or 150cc vehicle and so on. So here again, the motor power will be keep changing, and for each applications, each of the vehicles, the motor has to be separately designed. And another part in the motor design itself is the kind of the winding, which is it is a distributed winding, and how best that you are going to use it. And the second part is that the permanent magnets, which is going to be the process, and then the sheet is to be shaped for the particular and the type of motors or power requirements which we are going to use. So I hope that there is a lot of opportunities for the researchers and the members of faculty to get into the electrical vehicle design. And each area that there can be many and as many number of entrepreneurs can come up depending upon the their interest and then what they wanted to do it. And therefore that this particular topic, which the Department of Electrical Engineering of KSRCT has taken up, is one of the most important topic. So I wish the organizers all the very best. And also I wish the participants will be, you will gain useful information through this particular faculty development, the program. I take these opportunities to thank AICT for having considered K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology for having given us an opportunity to conduct this particular program. I once again welcome Dr. Thangavel, who has readily accepted, our former colleague. We are really very happy the way in which that he is doing it at NIT Puducherry. And hope that he will continue to success and do something. Joined as a professor and then the head of the department, and then he has become the dean academic of that particular NIT. I hope that his leadership will bring laurels to the NIT itself. So thank you so much for the opportunities. Wish you all success for the participants, and wish you all success for the organizers as well. Thank you, and over to MOC.
Thank you, sir, for inspiring words. Your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more. And your endless care, guidance, and support prove that you are a great leader. Now I request our beloved principal, Dr. R. Gopalakrishnan, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, to address the gathering.
Good morning. Hope I'm audible and my video is enabled.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Respected Chairman, line Dr. K. Rangaswamy, respected Vice Chairman Mr. R. Srinivasan, most respected our CEO Dr. K. Tyagaraja, today's chief guest, the former head of the Department of K. Rangaswamy College of Technology, and the Dean Academics and Associate Professor of NIT Puducherry, Dr. S. Thangavel, head of the department, Dr. M. K. Lango, organizing coordinator, and faculty members of K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, and participants from various institutions of our country. Very good morning, all of you. Today, I'm really happy to join in this inaugural event of the ATEL training program organized by Department of EEE. At the outset, I must thank our AICT for sanctioning this 1 week FTP to our K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology EEE department. And also I extend my sincere thanks to the today's chief guest who is going to give the inaugural address, Dr. S. Thangavel. So welcome, sir, to our K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology virtually, and also my sincere thanks to you for accepting our invite, and we'll be giving the inaugural address. And coming to the topic, the challenges and opportunities in execution of AI for e-vehicle design. So this is in a really need of the hour topic, and we are having our chief guest as because for connect people say connecting dots, because in that way we have a great title and a great person going to inaugurate this particular FDP. And also if you look at the lined up resource persons, all are worked in e-vehicles, either in terms of research or fundings and all these things. And I wanted to touch upon one thing, because our CEO has already given enough details about e-vehicles and how AI has been implemented without our knowledge. But here, I also wanted to add upon 2-3 points. So electrical vehicle, because we have a lot of scope, because it is coming up, as Saras mentioned. One of the emerging areas is battery technology, because so many countries, they're working on lithium battery technology. That's one area it is picking up. And second one, flash charging, that is also known now. it has more weightage, and we can work on the research on that particular regard. And coming to artificial intelligence, because artificial intelligence, it's all now based on what need to be done based on the circumstances. That is what the artificial intelligence is all about. If you take a normal building, people call it as BMS, building management system, there it, in fact, the artificial intelligence has been included, implemented already, you know, years ago, at least 10 years ago, it has been implemented, and it has been, you know, followed in any of the electrical designs, electrical and ELV designs. So the AI process, you know, it is not new for us, and it is not new to the world also. It has been, you know, there for a long time. But coming to electrical vehicle, what are the, you know, requirements, and how it is going to, you know, play in a vital role in processing. So for anything and everything, we must need data. So as our receiver has mentioned, we must place sensors, and it's all like a SCADA, because, you know, we know very well supervisory control and data acquisition system. Similarly, for the electrical vehicle also, we can assume that it is in a different version of SCADA. So when an electrical vehicle, how it is going to know sense, even already we have a reverse, when we go going for in a reverse, we have the camera, and if you go very near to the object, it will give some kind of alarm, or it will give some kind of sound. So that is what one of the AI process. Similarly, there are a lot of things are there in electrical vehicle, in automotive vehicle. So now it is the more important aspect for the autonomous vehicle. That's what the autonomous vehicle and e-vehicle, it's all each and everything, it has its own connectivity and things. A lot of research is happening, and within 5 years of time down the line, so India also will be able to do a lot of things in this particular arena. So with this, I must thank the organizers for giving me the opportunity, and also I want once again I welcome our resource person and our chief guest of the day, Dr. Thangavel sir, for accepting our invite and gracing this occasion. Thank you, sir, and over to MOC.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words. The key is growth is the introduction to higher dimension of consciousness into our awareness. Now I request Dr. S. Gomathi, Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, to introduce our chief guest.
Thank you, Imusi. Esteemed chief guest, beloved principal, respected HOD, dear faculty members, and the most valued participants, a very good morning. We are honored this morning by the presence of Honorable Chief Guest Dr. S. Thangavel, Associate Professor and Dean Academics, National Institute of Technology, Puducherry. He did his BE degree in Government College of Technology, Coimbatore. He did his ME Control and Instrumentation in College of Engineering, Guindy, Anna University. He completed PhD in the Specialization of Intelligent Controller for Industrial Drives in Anna University in the year 2008. He has 24 years of teaching experience. He had published 69 papers in various national and international journals like Elsewhere and IET Power Electronics. He had published 21 papers in various national and international conferences. He guided 12 successful PhD programs. He had organized 37 programs such as conferences, seminars, and workshops. He had given 20 guest lectures in various institutions. He is a senior member in IEEE and life member in ISTE. He received fund of ₹16,20,000 from various funding agencies, which ended up successfully. He is a reviewer for various international journals and conferences. He is a chief editor for International Journal of Power System and Energy Management. He is a BOS member for 5 different institutions. He had received many awards. One of the notable awards is the National Award from the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, Government of India. His research work is focusing on social relevant issues like rural electrification through smart grid system and fabrication of robotic caliper for physically disabled persons. Thank you. Over to MOC.
Thank you, ma'am. Stars shine at night, some stars shine at bright daylight. It's our pleasure to welcome one such star. At the outset, it's our privilege to invite our honorable chief guest, Dr. S. Thangavelu, Dean, Academic Associate Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, NIT, Puducherry, to address the gathering.
Hey, thanks for the nice introduction. I hope that I am audible and visible.
Yes, sir.
So the CEO of KSR Education Institutions, the principal of KSRCT, HOD of EEE Department KSRCT, faculty and staff members of EEE Department KSRCT, volunteers and participants from various institutions. Good morning to all. I am for the inauguration of Federal Academy
Sir, excuse me, sir, you are not audible, sir.
Yeah, I think there is some interruption. So the Atal Academy sponsored FDBs are good initiatives of AICT to train the faculty members across the country on emerging areas. So the electric vehicles is one of the focused areas of Atal FDBs, consisting of 9 trust areas and 108 identified areas in engineering, management, art and craft, design and media, and life skill management. In this pandemic prevailing situation, the FDBs are conducted through virtual mode. So the advantages of attending a program through online is we can acquire the required information by sitting at our comfortable place. In addition, the recorded materials of all the resources presence of all the FDBs are available at the website. So anybody can refer at any time. So thanks to the Atal Academy for making such arrangements. So even though there may be a limitation interacting with the resource person in online mode of FDBs, I know that the resource persons are kind enough to interact with the participants through online, email, and social media. So if you see this topic, so worldwide, the talk of the world is COVID for past 10 to 11 months. So before that, the talk of the world is the pollution. Yes, the environmental pollution is one of the major issues which need attention. Countries across the world are taking the necessary steps and framing policies to diminish these pollutions. One of the causes of pollutants is transportation. So the electric vehicles are the solution to environmental pollution due to transportation. The electrical vehicles don't emit direct emissions. Electric vehicles are more eco-friendly than conventional gasoline powered vehicles. In this context, in order to promote and accelerate the manufacturing of electric vehicles, so both the central and state governments framed their policies. So the policies are focusing financial incentives to consumers, funding of infrastructure development, and consumer awareness initiatives. As an initiative, the Government of India launched the National Electric Mobility Mission Plan 2020 in the year 2013, followed by National Electric Mobility Mission Plan 2020 in the year 2015, with the financial support of thousands of crores rupees under different phases, focusing on technology development, demand creation, pilot projects, charging infrastructure in order to deploy thousands of electric vehicles on road in hundreds of major cities. Apart from the government policies and plans, many research and development works are in progress to manufacture economic and energy efficient electric vehicles. So the premier institutions in India and the vehicle manufacturing industries established research centers to promote research activities on electric vehicles. So there is researches on electric vehicles are taking place in most of the IITs, NITs, universities and institutions. Some of the institutions are also offering postgraduate program in electric vehicles. So if you consider the electric vehicle technology, the research areas include charging infrastructure, smart grid system, renewable energy based charging, energy storage and monitoring, automotive health monitoring, calibration and diagnosis, tribology. And in addition to that, the people are applying so many intelligent techniques or artificial intelligence, and so many the technologies are also incorporating to get the better results. So in continuation of the above, the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering of K.S. Rangasamy College of Technology is proposing to conduct FTP on electric vehicles, which deals the application of artificial intelligence in the some of the above areas. So congratulations to the convener, coordinators of EEE department. My appreciation to all resource person for their effort to deliver talk on the impact areas of electric vehicle technology developments. So it is happy to note that the participants are from across the country, and the coordinator of this program mentioned that around more than 17 departments are from more than 17 states. It is a very good thing. I hope that the outcome of the deliberation in this FTP will be beneficial to all the participants. My best wishes to all the participants and enjoy the outcome of this FTP. So thank you all. My best wishes to all. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable and informative speech. Thank you is the best prayer that anyone could say. Thank you expresses that gratitude, humility and understanding. With my pleasure, I would like to invite Dr. T. Venkateshan, Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, K.S. Rangasamy College of Technology, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Okay. Good morning to one and all gathered here. It is audible. It is audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Oh, yes, sir. Oh, okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. So, good morning to one and all gathered here. On this wonderful morning, I would like to present the vote of thanks. First of all, I thank the most respected chairman and respected vice chairman for giving us the platform to conduct this event. Thank you, sir. I take the golden opportunity to thank the respected chief guest of today's function, Dr. S. Thangavel, Dean Academic NIT Puducherry, for attending this function in his busy schedule. We will cultivate the idea you gave us in real life. Thank you, sir. I extended my gratitude to the respected Chief Executive Officer, Dr. K. Thyagaraja, not only for spending his time with us today, but also for encouraging us to fulfill many achievements. Thank you, sir. It is my great pleasure to thank the respected principal, Dr. R. Gopalakrishnan, for supporting us to apply for this program and also guiding us in all times. Thank you, sir. I sincere thanks to the head of the department, Dr. M. K. Ilango, for arranging this program in the first place and coordinating this FDP. Thank you, sir. I take this opportunity to thank Dr. D. Srividya and Ms. P. Satyapriya for organizing this FDP. Thank you, madam. My wholeheartedly thanks to all our staff members for enthusiastically arranging this function. Without you, this function would not be successful. Thank you all. We offer our sincere thanks to all participants of this event. I hope you have great experience and acquire good knowledge on things you learn in next 5 days. Thank you all. Once again, I thank you one and all attending this event. Thank you. Over to MOC.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Yeah, dear participants, kindly one announcement. The first session will be started at sharp 11:30 a.m. today. Before that, if you have any login credential issues, any username, password mismatch, kindly contact through WhatsApp. We will be there here to supporting you, right? So before 11:30, we will have even one mock participation also, if you need, right? So we will meet at 11:30 a.m. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.